Super Roller Dome, the men of bad attitude, powwowing, while the ladies are up. And in this first 45-second scoring cycle, with the Violators leading bad attitude by 14, the Jenners will be the Flea, Paula Wilson, in the black helmet for the Violators. She's out of Omaha, Nebraska. Behind her, the Latin Spitfire, Patsy Delgado, who's in her 13th year of skating. Neither woman gets any points on the wall. They both get two. Coming off the jet jump, and now they will approach the rear blockers, who are so important in this game. It is the job of the rear blockers to prevent the Jenners from passing the opposing players and scoring points. Sweet Stephanie is at wild. Red hair goes down as the bopper bops her. That opens it up for the Latin Spitfire, who gets around all three Violator opponents, gets those 3 points, and stops the cycle.
Now here's how you score on the wall of skating. Above that top line, it's 6 points. You can take three big strides. Below it, it's 2 points. And of course, on the jump, same thing. 6 points over that big 12-foot marker and 2 points behind it. But remember, you have to land safely to get the points.
Now Stephanie is taking on all comers now. Two on one, that's the bopper. And now tangling hair to hair with the Latin Spitfire as Mike Garth perhaps smartly backs in.
Oh, that's Stephanie. She's really a speed devil.
The bopper is back. Garth, who probably has the most beat up eyeglasses in all the galaxy, is lecturing sweet Stephanie.
A Violator vixen right there. And tonight she's taking on Patsy Delgado. I can't figure out which one has a bigger mouth.
Hellion, Tornado, Calamity Jane, all rolled into one. The Flea, Paula Wilson's black uniform is covered with white. As you watch the two managers argue.
Georgia
Haas versus
she's in bad trouble this time. She went over the edge.
She knows no fear, and she is watching her rear camera. Ron Christopher, nope, she only got two, so did Sweet Stephanie.
Unbelievable.
Sweet Stephanie, whoop, does it appear that Hot Rod is headed for deep water?
Bam, she's dead.
Sweet Stephanie moves on, meanwhile. Excellent skater coming up now on the tank, Barney Smith. Down goes the tank. Now it's the Latin Spitfire. She clobbers and moves out of the way for another point.
Stephanie's on a war path now.
Past Sadie Pressman for a third point with less than 5 seconds left. She stops the cycle. And the Violators lead by 15 points.
Don't use your hands. Let's go.
Close to a penalty there.
Paul Gallegos, the referee, saying, don't use your hands.
Do not buy the Sweet Stephanie doll. It can be devastating to your children.
Sweet Stephanie leads the Violators, who are now going to jet with Nasty Nancy Wilkinson. Meanwhile, Bad Attitude is going to go with the brat Lyle Morse, whose grandfather, true story, produced Ronald Reagan's first movie. It was entitled Smashing the Money Ring. And the brat gets two on the wall, as does Nasty Nancy. He gets two coming over the jet jump. Nasty Nancy has lost her helmet. And she has also lost her balance. The brat will try to get around the woman they call Sidecar. Nasty Nancy finds that the track is too high where she tried to re-enter. But she had to skate to a lower portion. That is wasting valuable time for the Violators, as the brat scores well with less than 5 seconds left in this scoring cycle. It ends with the brat celebrating.
There's one of the baddest fans in the world right there. Lyle Morse. He's number two on your screen. But then again, I don't want to talk about this team. Get him off there, Jeff. Get him off there. Thank you.
60-47 is the score.
It's Georgia Haas once again disrupting game play. Remember, there's only 6 minutes in each quarter. Every time this nonsense happens, all it does is run down the clock. Get her out of there.
That was the Flea she was mauling. We mentioned earlier the white powder on the uniforms. That's plaster of Paris that they sprinkle on the track so the skates will grip.
I don't understand how she gets away with that kind of nonsense with these referees.
She's a veteran and knows where that invisible line is. And dealing with the referee, Sweet Stephanie, oh, in trouble. She'll not even make the jetway. The whip was a bit strong. She's now going to back to
Lingle.
Meanwhile, Gladys Spitfire has got none on the wall and gets two on the jump. And you're right, you're not allowed to go the wrong way on this one-way track, which Sweet Stephanie just did. Big break for Bad Attitude. Perhaps they can close that 15-point spread. Spitfire. Can she get around the fast gang, Sweet Stephanie, before the cycle ends? 5 seconds, four, three. Sweet Stephanie down for the count. Bad Attitude at halftime trails only by 11.
Coming up, Rolling Doors has that big post update that we've been promising you. Stay with us. And later, Rocks the Super Roller stage, and the Jackson Brothers continue their feud.